Hello everyone. In this video, we will be discussing all the quantitative aptitude questions in the mock test 2. It was the free mock test we provided for the preparation of Wipro Elite NTH. So before proceeding, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Also join our Telegram channel for various placement preparation videos and off-campus updates. At the end of this video, don't forget to comment on the video and share your feedback. So let's start. So check this question. A stationery seller had some pens, sharpeners, erasers and pencils. He sells 65% of the total units and still has 175 units. We need to calculate originally he had how many units. Let us consider originally he had X units. So if he sells 65% of total units, he still has 35% of total units, right? So 35% of total units will be equal to 175. So X will be equal to 175 into 100 divided by 35. 35 5 is 175. So total number of units he originally had was 500 units. Okay. So what we have done, we have taken total units as X. They told that 65% were sold. So definitely 35% were remaining. And they also told that remaining units were 175. Okay, so the answer for this question is 500 units. Three bags contain 3 red, 7 black. So first bag contains 3 red and 7 black. Second bag contains 8 red and 2 black. And the third bag contains 4 red and 6 black. Okay. So three bags contain 3 red, 7 black, 8 red, 2 black and 4 red and 6 black balls respectively. One of the bags is selected at random and a ball is drawn from it. If the ball drawn is red, find the probability that it is drawn from the third bag. Okay. Now first step is we need to find the probability of getting a red ball. And second, we are going to find the probability that the ball will be from third bag. Okay. Now, what is the probability that the ball will be red? Now, here we need to use and or concept of probability very effectively. We know that and is multiplication and or is addition. Now, they are going to choose one bag and then choose one ball. So, the probability of choosing first bag is 1 by 3. And I will choose a ball, probability that the ball will be red is 3 by 10. Or I will choose second bag. Probability of choosing second bag is 1 by 3. And I will choose a ball, probability that the ball will be red is 8 by 10. Or I will choose third bag, probability of choosing third bag is 1 by 3. And I will choose a ball, probability that the ball will be red is 4 by 10. Now, this is the probability that the ball will be red. Okay. So you can just, if you want, calculate this. Okay. So this will be 1 by 10 plus 8 by 30 plus 4 by 30. Okay. So if we want to keep this, we can keep this 3 by 30. So this will become easy for calculation. So this will become 15 by 30, which is 1 by 2. Okay. Now, they want us to calculate that the probability that the ball drawn is red and it should be from the third bag, okay? Now, probability that the ball drawn is red, the chances are 1 by 2. Now, we need to calculate that the ball drawn is red. We need to calculate the probability that it is drawn from the third bag. Now, the probability that the ball is red is 1 by 2 and the probability that the ball drawn is red from the third bag is 1 by 3 into 4 by 10. That's what we calculated over here. So this is the total number of chances, or you can say sample space. And this is the probability that the ball drawn is from the third bag. So just calculate this. This will be 4 by 30 divided by 1 by 2. So this will be 4 by 30 into 2. So this will be 4 by 15. So the correct answer for this question is 4 by 15. Initially, we calculated the probability that the ball is red. And after that, we calculated the probability that it is drawn from the third bag. This is the event or the number of chances that it will be from the third bag. And this is the total probability that the ball will be red. So the effective answer is 4 by 15. A can do a piece of work in 10 days. B can do the same work in 20 days. With the help of C, they completed the work in 4 days. So A plus B plus C, 4 days. Then they are asking C alone can do the work in how many days. First step, we'll find total work. Total work will be nothing but LCM of 10, 20 and 4. LCM of 10, 20 and 4 is 20. So total work is 20 units. Now we'll find rate. Rate is nothing but work done per day. A takes 10 days to complete 20 units. So in one day, he will complete 20 divided by 10. That is 2 units per day. B takes 20 days for 20 units. So per day, he will complete 1 unit per day. All three of them together complete the total work in 4 days. So per day, they are completing 20 divided by 4. That is 5 units per day. So per day work of A plus per day work of B plus per day work of C will be equal to per day work of A, B and C together. So definitely 2 plus 1, 3 plus 2 will be equal to 5. So per day work of C is 2 units per day. So if C is completing 2 units per day, to complete 20 units, he will take 20 by 2, that is 10 days. So the correct answer is 10 days. C will take 10 days to complete the work, working alone. Two taps M and N can separately fill the cistern in 30 and 20 minutes respectively. So M takes 30 minutes to fill the tank. N takes 20 minutes to fill the tank. They started to fill a cistern together, but tap A is turned off after a few minutes and tap B fills the rest part in 5 minutes. After how many minutes was tap M turned off? Okay, so first let us calculate total capacity of that cistern, which is LCM of 30 and 20. LCM of 30 and 20 is 60 units. So capacity of that tank is 60 units. Let's find rate. Rate is nothing but amount filled per minute. M takes 30 minutes to fill 60 units. So per minute it will fill 2 units, right? 2 units per minute. N takes 20 minutes to fill 60 units. So per minute it will fill 3 units. The rate will be 3 units per minute. Now check the situation. Suppose this is the amount to be filled, that is 60 units. Okay, initially M and N together start filling. We don't know for how many minutes. Let us consider X. Okay, after this point of time, M leaves. Okay, so at this point of time, M is turned off and the remaining part is filled by N in 5 minutes. Okay, so now just check over here. N fills 3 units in 1 minute, right? So in this 5 minutes, how much unit will N fill? In 1 minute, it fills 3 units. So in 5 minutes, it will fill 15 units. So during this 5 minutes, 15 units are filled by N alone. So that means in this initial time, 45 units were filled. Right, total work capacity to be filled is 60 units. In last 5 minutes, N fills 15 units. So in initial some time, M and N together fill 45 units. When M and N together work, M fills 2 units per minute plus N fills 3 units per minute. So together they fill 5 units per minute. They need to fill 45 units. So if they fill 5 units in per minute, then to fill 45 units, they are going to take 9 minutes. So in initial 9 minutes, M and N together fill that 45 units. So from this, I can say after 9 minutes, tap M was turned off. So for initial 9 minutes, M and N together, they were working. After filling 45 units, M is turned off. And in the remaining 5 minutes, N completes the work by filling 15 units. So the answer for this question is 9 minutes. A clock is set right at 1 p.m. Okay. If it gains 1 minute in 1 hour. Okay. Gains. What is the true time when the clock indicates 6 p.m. on the same day. So such kind of problem, just check how you can solve. I'll write here defective clock and correct clock. Okay. Both clocks, you can say they are set at 1 p.m. Then they are saying the defective clock gains 1 minute in 1 hour. That means when 60 minutes are covered in correct clock, 61 minutes are covered in defective clock because it has gained 1 minute in 1 hour. Now they are asking us the true time. That means we need to calculate the time elapsed in correct clock because they are asking us the true time. When the clock indicates 6 p.m. on the same day. So this defective clock is now showing 6 p.m. It was set at 1 p.m. Now it is showing 6 p.m. How many hours have elapsed? Total hours elapsed are 5 hours. So 5 hours means total 5 into 60, that is 300 minutes have elapsed in defective clock. Let us calculate how many minutes have elapsed in correct clock. So just we can calculate it like this, 60 into 5 into 60 divided by 61, which will be equal to x. So the many minutes have elapsed in the correct clock. Okay, so these many minutes have elapsed. So if I just divide this by 60, so I can say 300 by 61 hours have elapsed in the correct clock. Now the correct clock was also set at 1 p.m. right? So 300 by 61 hours means, let us check how much this will be, 300 by 61. So if I multiply this by, if I divide this, then 5s will be more than 3 hours. So I can write here 4 hours. So 61 into 4, it will be 4 hours and 56 by 61 hours. So that means 4 hours complete and remaining 56 by 61 hours. So I can say it is 5 p.m. And now we need to calculate minutes. How we can calculate minutes? So this can be 56 into 60 upon 61. So we need to just calculate this. So this will be 3360 divided by 61. So this will become 55.5 by 61 minutes. Okay. So I can say the correct clock indicates 55.5 by 61 minutes past 5. Okay, so 55.5 by 61 minutes past 5. This is the timing shown by the correct clock. Check this question. A grocer has a sale of 6435, 6927, 6855, 7230 and rupees 6562 for 5 consecutive months. Okay, so they have given us the amount of sale for first 5 consecutive months. Okay, in the first month, the sale is 6435. Then it is 6927, 6855, 7230 and 6562. Okay, now what they're asking, how much sale he must have in the sixth month so that he gets an average sale of 6500. So how much he must have in the sixth month so that average becomes 6500. So average is 6500. Total will be total of first 5 months plus sixth month divided by 6. Okay, so here you can check, this will become 39,000. I multiplied 6 over here, will be equal to total of 5 months plus sixth month. So 6th month sale will be equal to 39,000 minus total of 5 months. So let's calculate the total of 5 months. Okay, you can just calculate this. 79. Okay, 4, 6, 11, 14, 20, 15. Plus 8, 23, 25, 30, 18, plus 3, 21, 28, 35. So this is 34,009. So 39,000 minus 34,009 will be equal to 4991. Okay, so he must have a sale of rupees 4991 in the sixth month so that the average becomes 6500. Okay, A, B and C started a business by investing each rupees 10,000. So A invested 10,000, B invested 10,000 and C also invested 10,000. After 4 months, A withdraws 3,000, B withdraws 4,000 and C invests 3,000 more. At the end of the year, a total profit was rupees 32800. Okay, at the end of year, that means 1 year. Okay, so now we need to find the share of C. So now we know that all of them are there for 12 months. So this is the investment and the time all of them are there for 12 months. Now, but out of these 12 months, they have changed their investments. We know that profit ratio is investment multiplied by time. Okay. So this 10,000 investment of A was there for how many months? We know that after 4 months, A withdraws rupees 3,000. So this 10,000 investment was there only for first 4 months. So investment multiplied by time plus after that, he withdraws 3,000 means his investment is 7,000 for the remaining 8 months. So this is about A. It's two. Let's check about B. After 4 months, B withdraws 4,000. So for first 4 months, his investment was 10,000. And after that, his investment becomes 6,000 for remaining 8 months. Let's check about C. After 4 months, C invests 3,000 more. So for first 4 months, his investment was 10,000. And after that, what happens? He invests 3,000 more. So now his investment is 13,000 for remaining 8 months. So now we have to just reduce this ratio. So 10,000 into 4 will be 80,000. This will be 7,000 into 8 will be 56,000. 40,000 plus 56,000 will be 96,000 is 2. This is 48,000 plus 40,000 is 88,000 is 2. This is 1,04,000 plus 40,000 is 1,44,000. Okay. So I can just cancel this. I can divide by 4. I can still divide by 2. So this is the final profit ratio. Okay. So now we'll take common multiple x. A's share will be 12x plus B's share will be 11x plus C's share will be 18x. Will be equal to total profit of 32800. So you can just check this will become 41x is equal to 32800. X will be equal to 800. So X is 800. We need to find share of C. Share of C is 18 into X, which is equal to 18 into 800. So this is 14400. Okay, 14,400 is the share of C. So in this sum, the main thing was whenever there is change in the investment, you need to solve it like this. Okay, for first 4 months, the investment was 10,000. Next 8 months, the investment was 7,000. Similarly for B and C, we got the profit ratio and in that ratio, we divided the final profit of 32,800. By taking common multiple. In the first 10 overs of a cricket game, the run rate was only 3.2. So run rate, first let us understand, run rate is nothing but total runs divided by number of overs. Okay, so for first 10 overs, the run rate was 3.2. That means total runs for 10 overs divided by 10 is 3.2. So total runs scored in 10 overs were 32. What should be the run rate in the remaining 40 overs to reach the target of 282 runs? So now you can check, in first 10 overs they have scored 32 runs. Okay, they need to reach the target of 282 runs. Okay, so how much more they have to score? 282 minus 32, which is 250 runs. Now to score these 250 runs, they have got 40 overs, right? So to score 250 runs in 40 overs, the run rate should be 250 divided by 40. So here it will be 4, 6 are 24, 6.25. Okay, so the run rate for the remaining 40 overs should be 6.25 to reach a target of 282 runs. 16 men can do 50% of work in 10 days. So from this, can I say to complete 100% of work, they will require 20 days. So 16 men complete the full work in 20 days. 10 women can do 75% of the same work in 15 days. So they are saying 10 women complete 75% of the work. They take 15 days. Okay, so 75% means 3/4 work they take 15 days. So for remaining 1/4 work, they will definitely take 5 days. So to complete full work, they are going to take 20 days. Okay, so I can say 10 women can complete the whole work in 20 days. They are asking how many days can 80% of the work be done by 8 men and 5 women. Okay, so first let us calculate the one day work of one man and one woman. Okay, so let us check, 20 is the total work, 20 units. Why? Because LCM of 20 days and 20 days, it will be 20. This is the time required for 16 men and 10 women. Check the rate. Rate will be 1. So rate of 16 men is 1. So rate of 1 man will be 1 by 16. Rate of 10 women is 1. So rate of 1 woman will be 1 by 10. Now what they are saying? They are saying the 8 men plus 5 women. Okay. So 8 men plus 5 women. Total work we know it is 20 units. Okay. What will be the rate? 8 men rate will be 8 by 16 plus 5 women, the rate will be 5 by 10, right? So the total rate will be 1. Okay, so 8 men and 5 women will take 20 days to complete full work. Why? Because they are doing 1 unit per day. So to complete 20 units, they will take 20 days. Okay, this is for full work, but they don't want for full work. So for 100% work, they are taking 20 days, right? So for 10% work, they will take 2 days, right? Then for 80% work, they will take 16 days. 10 into 8 is 80, 2 into 8 is 16. So the correct answer is 16 days. In 16 days, 80% of the work can be done by 8 men and 5 women. The sides of the triangle are in the ratio 3:4:5. Okay, so I can take common multiple x. First side is 3x, second side length is 4x, third side length is 5x. The perimeter of the triangle is 60. So addition of all these three sides is 60. Okay, so 12x is 60. So x will be equal to 5. I got the value of common multiple. So the first side is 15 centimeters. Second side is 20 centimeters and the third side, you can check, is 25 centimeters. Okay, so now you can check, this triangle will be like this. So this will be 25, this can be 20 and this can be 15, right? So this appears to be right angle triangle. If you want to check, just check if Pythagoras theorem is applicable. So 25 square is 625. Hypotenuse square should be equal to the sum addition of side square. So 20 square is 400. 15 square is 225. So it is 625. Correct. So this is a right angle triangle. So they are asking area. Area will be half of 15 into 20. Okay. So the area is 150 centimeter square. So the answer for this question is 150 centimeter square. Okay, check how you can solve this type of question. They are saying x is root 5 plus 2. Then we need to find the value of x square plus 1 upon x square. Okay, let's go stepwise. First, let us find the value of x square. X square will be root 5 plus 2 the whole square. So it will be 5 plus 2 into 2 into root 5 plus 4. So this will be 9 plus 4 root 5. Okay, I have just applied the formula of a plus b the whole square. Now let us find what will be 1 upon x square. So 1 upon x square will be nothing but 1 upon 9 plus 4 root 5, right? So in your school days, you might have learned how to solve this type of problems. I will just multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number, okay, which is 9 minus 4 root 5. I have multiplied in denominator, and with the same number I will multiply in the numerator. It is 9 minus 4 root 5. Let's check what happens now. 9 minus 4 root 5 upon, this is a plus b, a minus b. A plus b, a minus b is a square minus b square. So b square will be what? 16 into 5, this will be 80. Okay. So here you can check, it will be 9 minus 4 root 5. So 1 upon x square is also 9 minus 4 root 5, and 1 x square is 9 plus 4 root 5. So x square upon 1 upon x square is 9 plus 4 root 5 plus 9 minus 4 root 5. So 4 root 5 gets cancelled. The answer is 18. So the answer for this question is 18.